4 ounces of our oven meal, cream of tartar, and then our color. So what you're going to do first when we go, you guys go back, is you're going to take your egg whites, pour them inside, and then we're going to start it up. You can, and this is different again, I've worked with different chefs who've done different things where they put the cream of tartar in the egg whites before they start. Some of them start until it starts getting a little frothy and put it in. So it really doesn't make a difference when you put this in, but you want to do it before it starts turning into meringue. And this just helps stabilize your meringue so they don't fall apart.
Another trip to Hawaii. Okay. So just kind of rein it in like this so that it goes in slowly, so that it's not getting to be all clumped up. It's okay to turn around hot. You don't get to use that feed very often, especially when you use the flour because it flies all over the place. And then it's going to go inside our sifter. And then we're just going to take our bowl scraper and just sift them together. You don't want to use a really, really fine sifter because it'll take you all day to get through the whole. We're not really doing this to sift to get too much out. We're actually kind of aerating it, getting a little lumps. When you use powdered sugar straight from the bag and you haven't opened it, you won't have lumps because air hasn't gotten to it. But if you have it open and sitting out, you're going to get lumps because the air has gotten to it and it makes it, the moisture keeps it together.
Are they okay?
The only problem is that when you use those, sometimes you get the stuff in so you lose some of that. But it's not going to make that difference.
It might get stuck.
Yeah, you just kind of tap it right there. It's by itself, so it'll turn the butter, and you don't want it really wet. So when you grind it, you want to add a little bit of pepper and you add a little cream to it. When you add your flour and you fold it in, how much you are going to pop the bubbles to make it flow. So you want it to be flowing, but we don't want it to be running. If it runs, it'll move out of it. When we pipe them, it will stay within that circle. It'll spread a little bit, but it'll stay within that circle. Pick it up. Okay, that's too soft.
Too soft.
And you want a firm peak. We want to stand at attention.
You can do it inside this bowl if you want, but there is that round peak at the bottom too that you have to be careful for.
It doesn't work.
So
it's harder.
It's easier to move into a bowl. So if you have a big bowl, put it in the bowl.
I was thinking I can eat two, three.
And that way, because you're going to make buttercream as well, you're going to need this bowl again, so you have to wash it. So hopefully you have somebody in your kitchen that will be washing your dishes for you. While you are making the next batch.
Okay.
When do you put the color in? Do you beat it in there, or don't want to swirl it
if you're going to color. Yes, so I didn't put mine in now because I'm going to swirl mine in. You would do it at the very end, right before you're done. So you don't want to put the color in at the beginning because by the time you whip it, you're going to add more air. It's going to be a different color.
You do it between the soft peak and the
soft. I would do it a little bit more before the hard peak, before the firm peak.
That's what I always struggle with, is when do I put the color in?
So at the very, depending on how vibrant you want it to be. So if you want to save the color that you make it, do it closer to the end. Even if you did it now, you forgot, you could always just flip it in right now. Just fold it in.
Then it gets a brighter color.
Some people I've done this with, and they're like, oh, we can just take it and make three separate, a third of each, right? And then we scoop it up with this. Or, if you're home, you can take your parchment paper, and you would just pour it like this into the batter. So this is the part where, I said, we've been doing this, and I realized one day, like, oh, we're only sifting it once, because I would have them put it in there, and we wouldn't fold it. And so what you're going to do here is you'll have somebody help you, or if you're doing it by yourself, then it's easier to do this part and go like this. Fold it in. So you're going to do the third. This, no. Colors back along, and I don't know why I was doing that. It gets them faster. All right. So now we're going to fold our macaron, our flour into it. And you don't need to fold it completely in at the first time, because it's, if you fold in every single time all the way thoroughly, by the time you get to the end, it's going to be water. Okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to fold this in until we don't see so much clumps, but we'll still see a little dryness. And then, because at the end is when we're going to go ahead and make it the macaronage, where it's beating in the egg whites or breaking the bubbles. So what you want to do is you want to go from the center down the middle, from the top to down the middle, and then flip, scoop from the bottom and flip it over. Okay? Turn it a quarter turn. Same thing. Drum underneath the bottom, flip it over. Okay? And then we're just going to go all the way around a couple times. And you'll see that we're just kind of mixing it in there. So that's one group right there. Okay? So now we've done one third.
If you sifted it twice, then you don't need to sift it on top of it then?
Like I said, I could even just pour, like take this, and that's what we were doing the first couple classes. Mm-hmm. We were just like doing this, but I forgot about using the sifter again. Like just pour a third in. So they only did it once. And there was no difference in the one that we've done in one. There's no difference in the one we've done two. There's no difference that we've done three. And there's no difference we've done enough that we did the whole food processor thing and did it. If I don't have to do it, I don't want to. But I have not seen, like I said, the classes that I've taught, the students have made every one of their macaron has come out beautiful. So it's got a high standard to live up to. On a rainy day, it may take longer for your skin to form on top of the macaron because it's more moist outside. So it may take you an hour, and sometimes on a hot day, it may take you 15 minutes. So it all depends on how the humidity is in the air and how fast your skin forms. Now this is where we're going to take it and go a little longer in our folding, and then at the end we're going to start not being so gentle. We're going to actually start popping our bubbles. So, boy, that was so gentle. No, you don't. Just you need to make sure how gentle you can be until you need to be tough. Like raising kids. You know when you got to do the tough love. Foil. If we go like this, it doesn't look like lobster, right? Mm-hmm. It's sticking to the spoon, yeah. It's not coming down. Yeah. We want it to flow down from the spoon, and then when it gets to the bottom, we want it to fall into itself. So you think about when we're doing the cookies and we're actually piping them, if it's too firm, and you go like this and you pipe them, you're going to have this candy kiss type thing, and it's going to stay up there. What we want is when it folds, when we do it, you may have a little bit of candy kiss on there, but then it's going to fall into itself to make itself nice and smooth and round. Okay? So, we're just going to keep doing this, and then once we get it all in there, now we're just going to start popping our bubbles. So, at first when you do it, you can see it's kind of dry looking and it's matty, and as we start doing this, it's going to start getting glossy again. Okay, so it's called macaronage, and that means they're popping the bubbles.
Called what? Macaronage.
The word.
So,
so you're doing that again until it falls. It's still not falling, but it's starting to come off now. Okay.
First day, you're supposed to let them sit. You're supposed to let them sit, but then you're supposed to take them out at room temperature. Most people
take
them
out. All right, so you keep it in the fridge for
a day. You do keep them in the fridge.
You can keep them in the fridge. I've always kept mine out. I've never.
Do you keep your butter out too?
Yes.
Me too.
The thing with the butter though, and here's the funny thing, I started thinking when I always kept mine, because that's how we grew up.
Yeah.
Food on the stove, never put away chicken out, you know? Like not whole chicken, but like fried chicken.
Yeah.
It was out. Beans, rice, it was out on the table, on the stove, and we ate it. And it's like, that's why we never get sick.
Yeah.
Not now, actually.
So control your salt. We grew up with salted butter. It didn't taste that much more salty when we were making our cookies and stuff like that. So, All right, so here we are. We're starting to get a little softer. And you look, so what you're looking for is
put it down into it, how it falls into itself.
Oh, yeah.
Does it stay up, or as it goes, is it disappearing? And that's what you wanted to do, okay? So you want it to disappear. And you also want to remember that when you are getting to disappear into itself, so we want that. We want it to come off the spoon where it's falling straight down. And then once it gets down there, it's going to soften into itself.
Okay.
Because we're going to also bang that at the end to help get the air bubbles out, and it's going to make it spread more. Again, if you go further than this, the possibility of you having it to be too runny is going to be more, just by the time you piping. Okay. So it is a 12. So we have a round tip. What we do is we put it in the bag. You can use a coupler or not a coupler. We don't use a coupler.
She said 10 or 12.
Just be good. This is a 12, yeah. I didn't have my glasses on earlier, so I couldn't see it. What we do is if you're using a coupler, a lot of people who use cake decorating use couplers because they can keep the different, change out the tips. If you're not used to working with a bag, sometimes the tip will go up into the bag if it's not tight. So the coupler is good for that as well. Again, I don't like to wash dishes if I don't have to, so I try not to use it. But we put it inside, drop it in, and normally we will turn it so that when we fill the bag, it won't automatically start dripping out. Okay, so that's one way to do it. You can take and you can use your hand to open it up and do it like this and fill it, or you can take a cup and put it over the top like this. Okay. So in this case, I'm going to make it a little hard. So I'm going to stripe these, and remember you have a top and a bottom. So if you do your striping and the bottom ones come out, or the first ones come out kind of plain, that's okay. That can be your bottom. Not a big deal. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take my color, my food color, and I'm going to take my, and I'm just going to do stripes along the side here. Okay. And what this is going to do is when the batter runs down, it's going to pick up that and make stripes or marble effect. Not so much stripes because we're going to be turning it and doing that kind of stuff. But it will make it a marble effect on your cookie. And it just falls into your cup. And you don't want to fill your bag all the way up. You only want to do half at a time. Because if you fill it up too much, then it's going to come out the other side, and you're going to have a mess. And you'll lose like two cookies. That's why I want to see bowls that are pretty clean. Because that's always looking, that's two more cookies in there, guys. If you don't want them, I do. Or my staff does. So this is where you, what you want to do is you want to take your bag, you want to make sure it's enough up here that you've got a good clean area. You're going to twist it, and you want it to make this fat. Okay, so when you're pushing down, you want that to be a fat ball like. And you're going to hold it with these two fingers here. Okay, so your thumb and your forefinger is going to like a cook bag. You're holding it like that. Okay, so that's going to keep it closed. Every few times you do a few cookies, you want to turn it a few times so that it stays fat. You're using these three fingers here to squeeze, okay? And this hand can use to guide it, but you don't want, I don't want to see death grips, and I don't want to see squeezing from the middle, okay? That's where it's going to come out the other side and have a mess on your hands. When you pipe these, you want to be straight up and down, okay? So you want to go straight up and down. You're going to count to like three or four until it fills the circle. And then what you're going to do is you're going to like flick away. So some people call it a comma. Some people call it just flicking away. Depends on how you want to think. But just think, when you're doing this, you want to go one, two, three, four. Tell yourself to stop squeezing, lift up, and then flick away or kind of go into a comma. Okay? But the key is to make sure you're straight up and down. A lot of bakers will go at an angle because they're used to
decorated at an angle.
Mm.
So you want to be it straight.
Four.
Tray moves. So don't think that you're here and you're like, way over here. Tray moves. Bring the tray to you. You don't have to go to the tray. Okay? So we're going to go straight up and down right here. So one, two, three, four, stop. And just flick away. Go into a comma. Flick away to the side. What you're trying to do is avoid that little, the little kiss to stand straight up and down. So you know, you see our color starting to come through. So if you're right-handed, so then you're gonna make another turn. Keep it facing up when you turn so that it doesn't come out. So usually one row is probably where you want to go, and then so you don't want to lift up, you don't want to be doing this, okay? You want to keep it in one spot and just kind of like a quarter inch from the thing and just keep piping, squeeze, 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 stop, and just off to the side. So whether it's just like this, or whether, like I said, if you're thinking about a comma, you know, you're not going around, you're not doing this, it will work. Because, I mean, but it's just not what you're supposed to be doing, but it will work.
Did the feet develop if you do it?
Yeah, it'll still develop. Like off to the side. So if you're, you know, we give you the templates, you should have a template there. Looking for like size together. So if you happen to have a small one, then you just find another one that's small. You want to make sure though that you're not doing purposely doing a big one and a small one on the same tray, because obviously your big one will cook a lot slower than your small one, and your small one will burn before your big one gets cooked all the way. You're gonna see that when we do these, some of them as we go further on may stay a little, just because of that we put so many in the oven at the same time. When it's dry, the skin forms, you'll be able to touch that and there will not be anything coming off on your skin. And then if you have this bowl scraper and your thing happens to be coming out the top, you can take it and use this to squish it down and clean it off. So that's why this is a really good one.
Did you make a whole recipe or a half recipe?
These are all whole recipes. So we have the templates underneath our parchment paper. If you forget to take the paper out, it's not gonna burn. It shouldn't burn. We use these over and over again. So you can take that one home, make some copies of it. And then you're gonna take it, and slam it on your thing like three times, okay? And what this does is it helps to bring any air bubbles out so that they come to the top and they stop. But you wanna hold the paper so it doesn't slide all over the place. So we're gonna put these over in the corner to dry out. Form the skins, and you guys are going to begin your
okay.
So that it's hotter from here than
out of the bag. So, we keep what? You should say we keep it in the bowl.
Gail, you're so good to win it.
Okay, Gail, if your arm is getting too tired,
yeah,
I would take my turn.
There you go.
No, but you have it.
No, I'm good.
Okay.
I think I got the handle, but.
Tina and Nicole would love for you to stand in the video.
Okay. Allie, what's it?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
The girls can try it. one from the movie. I do have a candy gel color.
Do you think the foam should be more like, not the ribbon, like right
so,
here?
I think it should be.
Like
a few more, and they accidentally.
So that seems like a key element to this.
Yes.
Right. So you guys want to?
So
sure.
Yeah,
you wanna try it.
You're doing it at this point, so
yes.
You can control how.
If you do too much the first and second, by the time you get to the third, you may be overdone.
And once you overdo it, you can bring it back.
Okay.
You can't do it enough again.
I think it's.
Yeah.
I think
maybe.
Yeah, see, it's still too thick. See how it's not falling off. It'll drip off.
Uh-huh.
Come off. See, it's starting to do a little bit better.
Yeah.
So a couple more turns. And
you would think. You mix the ingredients. And it becomes right.
Put a little color in there.
Mm-hmm. Okay, see how it's now it's starting to and it's getting a little shinier.
You put your elbow down to steady yourself.
That looks about right. See how it's kind of falling into itself?
Yeah, they were starting before we I
even,
was like, whoa,
even, even like this much left, it's still falling. Like
it's
a
little more
it's
fluid.
Shinier.
You
want
to
like,
yeah.
Feel it?
I'll feel it.
Yeah, I think it's easier if you feel it.
Yeah.
It is. Heavy or light.
Yeah. Oh, it's actually heavier than it was.
It's not there yet.
Because the air is
right,
gone.
Right,
can
we go see?
It's heavier.
You want to stay in the middle.
Oh, no, not in the middle.
No, you want to make sure you're straight down. Tell yourself to stop and then kind of turn off. So, straight up and down.
Yeah.
And then try to go off to the edge.
Off to the edge.
So tell you when you do count to like four.
Yeah.
And then stop squeezing and then lift up. But you want to go to the circle.
Is am I?
You, that one kind of missed a little bit, but
okay.
Okay.
And they do not expand to the side. They only go up, right? Because these circles are pretty close to each other.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be afraid they get stuck.
Yeah.
Don't move, right? Pretty.
I thought it was red. It looks orange.
Oh, the orange, yeah. Because it's but the flavor is orange flavor.
Ah.
Yeah.
So pretty.
They're
gonna be so cute.
And I hold it. Make sure when you stop, so you don't go into the cookie to do that. So you stop pulling up and then you do it.
It's harder than it sounds.
It is kind of.
You guys were down a little
so
bit.
One, two, three, four, stop, lift it up, and then kind of roll.
I think flick it.
Stop and lift up.
There. I think you guys were down closer.
Do you want to be up when you're lifting?
Alright,
if you put your thumb on the sheet so that it doesn't move to this one, yep. And
really hit
it, huh? Yeah, right, okay, really.
You don't have to
make a
whole lot of money.
Just.
Okay.
This is the
same thing.
So, Tina, you know that Balmoral cake that I made?
Mm-hmm.
The reason I think mine
reading
a recipe for.
It looks like it's the same thing.
You get the same.
So how about if I add some of the flour?
Yes.
Nope. Pardon? It may not matter, right?
I don't think so.
This is next year, too, I think.
Yeah. Almost done. So I go into jiggle. Hmm.
So when you go and you touch them, they shouldn't jiggle. That means they're still.
I know. She's got it.
We're going to finish. Whoop, that one didn't have enough.
Put in. It's usually pretty sweet, and a lot of people use that to frost cakes when they're learning to make cakes, and they just use that. The Swiss buttercream is the next one that's easiest to make. We're going to put this egg whites and the sugar in here, and we're going to whisk it until it says 160 degrees, or I don't use a thermometer. Usually it's just when you're whisking it, you'll start seeing it get nice and starts getting fluffy, kind of like your meringue was, and when you lift it up and it drips down, you won't feel the granules anymore. When you first start out, it looks like snot and it's all ugly looking, and then as you cook it, it melts those granules. You put it, you'll feel it's warm to the touch and you won't feel any granules in there. That's when you know it's ready. So if you don't want it, you can sit there and use a thermometer for that and just get it to the 160 or 165 that it tells you to do. But the other one's much easier. And then Italian buttercream is you have to use a thermometer. It's 243 degrees. You have to get your buttercream, your egg whites to that point. And then with the mixture going, you have to then take it, and you know it can't go over because it can't be too hot and it can't be too cold. And then you gotta slowly pour it in there and whisk it in there. First time I did, I was freaking out because I was afraid. It's like, what if it goes all over? And it's because sugar is one of the worst burns, right? It burns really, and I didn't want to splatter everywhere. It wasn't gonna be hot enough. And it did it, it worked, but I prefer this with two of the buttercream. So you guys will have the Nutellas and you're gonna do this one here. But we can have you guys come up here and work on this as I demo it. We have the orange juice, which we took orange juice in this 1.5 cups and we reduced it down. So now it's just really thick, it's concentrated. This is gonna give us some more flavor. And then we also have our zest. So this is a really, really flavorful.
How much to how much?
That was 1.25 cups.
1.25 cups.
And it comes down to about
2 tablespoons. Concentrate.
1.25 cups.
You put your pot on top. Some people say you can't make it touch the water. We've done it before where it's touched the water. It's worked out fine. You just don't want to make sure when you're doing, say you have a chocolate, you don't want it to get water inside the condensation inside your chocolate because it'll seize it. This is not doing that. So somebody wants to come up and they can start this one who's not doing the buttercream. So either one. Couple of your YouTube groups here can start, come up, one of you from anybody, because you guys will be doing yours. So what we're gonna do is throw the sugar and the egg white in here.
All right now, it's just gonna look like
no. He's no, he's right there. It's like it's all stuck together. If you were to go to touch it, you'll feel the granules like that. And you put your fingers there, feel the granules. Go ahead.
Egg whites and sugar.
Okay. So you feel the granules of the sugar. As you keep stirring them, it's going to start warming up and it's going to get white to do the rest. But if you do it this way, you can do it. So someone come over here and keep it medium heat.
You don't want the water boiling, right?
You don't want the water to boil. It's just a simmer. We still feel a little granules. It's still kind of cool. It's not warm enough yet. So we can still keep going. But this is now starting to cook the egg whites. They're getting nice and fluffy. And it's cooking the sugar, so it's going to... If you don't cook it, if you were to go now and put it on your mixer, buttercream. Darby, can you take the butters out of the refrigerator, please? There's two containers of butter. Anybody else? Come on, Ruth.
Okay, I'll see you in a minute.
And if you were to touch the bowl at the bottom, you're going to find that the bowl is hot. So we don't want to, we can't put cold butter in a hot mixer because it'll turn to soup. So what we're going to do now is we're going to cool it down by whisking it, and that's going to give us volume. And like you touch the bottom here, you feel it's hot. You want that to be cold before you start putting in your butter and everything else. So you can do one of two things. You can get one of the torches and warm it back up, and that'll bring it together. Or you can switch to a paddle, and the paddle will cream it. So if you are, right now we're whisking it. So if you have one you bring out of the refrigerator, you froze it, or it's in the refrigerator, and you start to do it with the whisk, and it starts to curl because you're adding air to it, and it's too cold, whisk through the paddle, and that will cream it. Just like butter when you're making cookies, so it's like creaming the butter. If you use some really warm and cold butter and you're doing it, it takes forever. You gotta wait and warm it up, and that's what you're doing with the paddle. So don't throw away next time.
Okay, like the ones you buy at the store?
Did you
use
this one?
Yeah, that one.
Okay.
Oh, it looks so
pretty.
It looks so pretty. So, there you go. It might
be
just
a little bit more. But
we'll have to take turns.
Yeah. And then you have teaspoons down.
Sure.
Okay.
I think so.
Was it in the
batter? Yeah, see, hers was more stringy.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead, whip it a little bit more.
But do we need to make it into like 1.5 bags?
You want to whip it?
Are you?
Did you want to whip it?
Sure.
You didn't whip it yet.